Mother Bilby brought her youngest daughter into the world when the rain first started. They believed that babies born during summer rains would bring good luck. However, this was no ordinary summer rain. In fact, it was only the beginning of the biggest hurricane these lands had ever seen. The rain pouring from the heavens caused a terrible flood, forcing animals in the woods to run. Only those who could not, or too stubborn to leave, remained. The Bilby family remained as well, because a long journey would be very dangerous for a newborn. All they could do was to barricade against the flood in their underground home. Despite all their efforts, the flood got in and dragged them away. The children grabbed onto the remains of the barricade. By a twist of fate, their way was blocked by a tree felled by lightning, saving the children but separating them from their mother. While the struggling mother felt a small amount of relief and the knowledge of her children's relative safety, she was dragged under the ground by the deadly flood.
I'm alive. I need to get out of here and get back to my kids. This place looks familiar. I'm glad I wasn't dragged too far away. Please be safe. That place doesn't look very sturdy. Swim. I hope I won't fall. I can jump across. I can gnaw those roots to free the rock, but I'm sure they taste disgusting. Going down? Mommy is on her way, kids. Hold on. Finally, I'm going up. But that spider is bigger than me. There may be a way down there. Understand why people are afraid of spiders, really. That was a long fall. He must be preparing for the winter, I guess. can dig through here. Oh no, this place doesn't go up either. Turtle shell? Woohoo! Anybody home? Sorry, I thought nobody was there. Hey, wait for me! Wait, stop! Why aren't you waiting for me? Turtle shell? Woohoo! Anybody home? Sorry, I thought nobody was there. Hey, wait for me. Wait, stop. Why aren't you waiting for me? I made it. Why aren't you waiting for me? Hey, I'm talking to you. Yoo-hoo! Can't you hear me, maybe? I wish you would answer me. Oh, come on. I wish you could hear me. How am I going to catch you again?
Thank you.
you so much. Next time, I will definitely visit you with my children. What is this lock doing here? Dig through from this side? Go up. Don't worry, kids. Your mother will get through this place too. Thank you. reach there. Mushrooms? Oh, I can't believe it. I remember having picnics under such mushrooms. I must keep this place in mind. My oldest must definitely see these. What a weird crystal. I wonder why it's glowing like that. I hope it's not dangerous. I wonder why it's glowing like that. I hope it's not dangerous.
Thank you.
While she was digging the path of earth in front of her, she had only a single thing in her mind. Her children. She did not care about the fall of the huge crystal, even though inwardly she knew how dangerous it was. She looked at the path upwards with hope and started climbing while raindrops fell on her face. Unfortunately, the crystal exploded. Meanwhile, I was trying to stop the magical hurricane. How could I know that a bilby would destroy one of the crystals that contained my magic and cause an earthquake? She froze when she saw me the first time. I could see the fear in the eyes of the poor little thing. When I started talking, I watched with immense pleasure as the fear was replaced by surprise. When we told each other what we had been through, seeing how surprise gave way first to sorrow and then to regret, broke my dying heart. I explained to her, if she accepted, I could pass on my remaining power and soul to her. This way we could exist together, to save her children and stop the rain. Her eyes shone with hope as our journey began. Let us take care of this darkness first. This may hurt a little, though.
But why?
You are not used to magic. Do not worry. I will only do this when it is absolutely necessary.
Okay, I'm ready. Wow!